If you want to get in contact with me, the best way to do it is on Instagram. If you just want to say what up, if you want to tell me you love my videos, you can tell me that you hate my videos, but the best way to do that is on Instagram. Peace, y'all. Johnny Fastlane here. So, hip-hop mogul Andre Harrell has passed away at 59 years old, and DMX says that he's willing to battle Jay-Z. Plus, Drake loses to Kenny Chesney. Let's talk hip-hop. This is unfortunate, right? And so this is the third time in the last like 2 weeks that I've sat up here and talked about somebody dying, right? Fred the Godson, coronavirus. King Shooter, coronavirus. And now Andre Harrell. It's unclear what Andre Harrell died from, but he passed away yesterday, right? And that was a clip of D-Nice DJing, and he announced it. And he was like, yo, I keep getting mad text messages, and it's hard for me to even DJ right now because of what's going on, right? So for y'all that don't know, Andre Harrell is a... one of the founders kind of hip-hop, right? So he started this record label called Uptown Records, that was like way back in the day, and he hired Diddy or Puff Daddy or Sean Combs or P Diddy or whatever y'all want to call him as just like an intern or whatever there, helping him out. So during that time, they, you know, signed people like Mary J. Blige, they signed like a Heavy D and the Boys, a few people, right? And then, you know, Puffy got hired full-time, so instead of being an intern, he was an A&R, so he was out there looking for new talent to bring to Uptown Records. So one of the people that Puffy like came across was, you know, Christopher Wallace or, you know, Biggie Smalls, right? But then Puffy got fired from Uptown Records, and then Puffy went on to start his own damn record label, and that one, you know, demo tape that he found of that rapper Christopher Wallace, he ended up signing Christopher Wallace to Bad Boy, and that was Biggie, the Notorious B.I.G. But so during this time, Andre Harrell started working at Motown Records. He was very instrumental in like New Jack Swing and like that whole sound, and Teddy Riley and that whole sound, Blackstreet and that whole sound. And like even today, Andre Harrell was working on State of the Culture with Diddy. Him and Diddy still remained friends for a very long time, up until now. He was actually a producer on State of the Culture, and he was working on a documentary on BET about Uptown Records and his time there back in the day. So this whole situation is crazy. 59 years old, especially in the year 2020, is still pretty young, right? It's not like he was 80-something. I'm more 90 something. And like I said, it's unclear why he passed away. It could be due to coronavirus, but we don't know yet, right? But either way, yo, it's just sad, right? Yo, let me know what y'all think about this in the comments.
But there's a Verzuz battle. You know, your brother Swiss Beats, my brother Swiss, putting together, you know, artists against artists. If you had a chance to battle any artist right now, who would DMX battle?
Yeah. Jay.
What? Are we saying Jay-Z?
Yeah, I think that's what he's saying.
Yeah, who you think?
Yeah. He going straight to the top. Which is only picking off where you guys already left off, right?
There you go.
A real battle.
Number three.
Right.
Why?
Yo, that would be epic for the culture right there.
epic for the culture, man.
All right, Joe. So that was a clip from Drink Champs, right? And so Nori is on there with DMX, and he's asking him, like, all right, with all these Verzuz battle, you know, with Swiss Beats and everybody, who would you battle if you had the opportunity to do it, right? And DMX is like, yo, Jay. And then Nori's like, excuse me? Come again? And he's like, yo, he's like, you mean Jay-Z? And DMX is like, hell yeah, like, who else would I battle? That's the only person that's on my level, right? And okay, like, a DMX and Jay-Z battle would kind of be fire, right? So I was thinking, like, who else is on, like, a DMX level that he would battle besides Jay-Z, right? Maybe 50 Cent, maybe, I don't know, maybe a Busta Rhymes, maybe a Method Man, right? But yeah, Jay-Z and DMX would be a dope ass battle, right? So, okay, so over the years, you know, Jay-Z has hits from like 1997 all the way into like last year, right? Where DMX, he was like on top of the world, but it was more like a 5 or 6 year like span, really, right? But during that time, DMX came out with a lot of shit, right? So like, all right, let's look at DMX's songs, right? Like Party Up, right? The Rough Riders Anthem, What's My Name, X Gonna Give It To You, How's It Going Down, Slipping, Falling, Can't Get Up, Get At Me Dog, We Right Here, Where The Hood At, We In Here, What These Bitches Want From A Nigga, You Been Eating Long Enough Now, Stop Being Greedy. Like, DMX got hits, right? But so does Jay-Z, all right? So Jay-Z, some of his songs, Run This Town, 99 Problems, Hard Not Life, Empire State of Mind, Big Pimpin', Holy Grail, Dirt Off Your Shoulders, I Just Wanna Love Ya, H to the Izzo, V to the Izzy, Can I Get A What? Like, it's crazy because DMX has a lot of hits, but so does Jay-Z, right? But I think that Jay-Z may have more hits than DMX just because, you know, DMX came out like in 98, Jay-Z came out in 97, which was like around the same time. But DMX like kind of fizzled out a little bit like around 2004-ish, right? And DMX is one of my favorite rappers in the world, right? But Jay-Z has always been like consistent. Even, you know, so the album with him and Beyonce, you know, and the album with him and Jay Electronica, like Jay-Z is still relevant right now, right? So I don't know, man, but this will be a good ass battle, yo. Let me know who y'all think will win a battle between DMX and Jay-Z in the comments. All right, so y'all know a couple days ago, Drake dropped Dark Lane demo tapes, right? And he dropped it with no warning. It was just like one day everything was cool, and the next day was like a new Drake album, right? But the whole thing is that Dark Lane demo tapes is not really like a bunch of new music, right? There are some new songs on there, right? Like a few new songs on there, maybe like 3 or 4, right? 2C Slide is on there too. That's one of the new songs. And also 2C Slide went like platinum within 24 hours when it first dropped because it blew up on TikTok. Right? So they included that on the album too, right? The whole situation is over the last 10 years and the last 9 albums or projects that Drake has dropped, they have all been number one on the Billboard Hot 100 charts every single time, right? But it seems like this time, Drake is going to be number 2 on the Billboard Hot 100 charts, but it doesn't really necessarily mean that he fell off or anything like that, because he's number 2 not to like another rapper, right? Not to like 6ix9ine or Lil Durk or Megan Thee Stallion or Tory Lanez or somebody. He's number 2 to a country singer, right? Kenny Chesney. And I don't even know who the fuck this Kenny Chesney dude even is, right? But apparently Kenny Chesney's a legend. He done dropped like 20 albums in the country music space. He's, you know, got like 30 different awards. He's always on the charts, and I guess, you know, Drake and him wasn't paying attention to this major country music star Kenny Chesney dropping, and they dropped on the wrong damn week, and now Kenny Chesney is still in Drake's number one spot. Kenny Chesney is stopping Drake's streak. Drake has been number one on the Billboard Hot 100 charts every single time he's dropped a project for the last 10 years in a row for some country music nigga named Kenny Chesney to come out of nowhere and block Drake. Crazy, right? Now Drake sells 226,000 copies of Dark Lane demo tapes, and he'll be debuting at number 2, right? But the whole thing is, this is not really an album. So that's how they're gonna get around it, right? This is not really an album. This is also a collection of older songs and songs that may have leaked throughout, let's say, the last 2 years or whatever like that. So if it debuts as number two and not number one, that's cool, because it ain't really an official Drake album like that, right? And that's the way that Drake is gonna have to like go around that with his stats, because if they were to include this as a real album, then man, I'm not saying Drake took a L, but he ain't get a W. But anyway, let me know what y'all think about this and everything else in the comments down below. Don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe. Make sure you hit that notification bell. Follow me at Johnny Fasten on Instagram, and y'all already know what to do. Peace.